All right, so as you can see, the car is now super low. Here's a look at the back as well. Not as low as the front, but still much lower than it was before. What's going on YouTube? In today's video, I finally lowered the BMW 435 on some KW V1 coilovers, so stick around. So I just want to say really quickly, if you're not already, hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell. It'll really help me out. Anyways, let's get into it. All right guys, so like I was saying, I lowered the BMW 435 again on some KW V1 coilovers. This video is not going to be a DIY, but I wanted to show you guys what the car looks like when it's lowered. I also wanted to give you guys sort of like a review of the KWs, how they ride, how expensive they were, and all that type of stuff. Yeah, anyways, let's cut to a couple clips of that. So hopefully you guys enjoyed that little montage, but here's the car over here, basically the finished product. So as you guys can tell, the car is super low, so kind of hard to see in the shadow over here. Let's see if the other side can get like a better idea. But yeah, if you guys can see that, it is super, super low. So this actually isn't even like the lowest that you guys can make the car with the KWs. You can go lower, but honestly, any lower than this is pretty insane. I don't even think I'm gonna keep it this low. When I did it, I didn't go too crazy in adjusting the ride height, but this felt good and I kind of liked it low for the Keys Motorsports show. So if I can give you guys sort of like a closer look over here. So in the front, you can barely even like put a finger in here. You definitely have to like bend it. The back actually isn't as low, so again, I can show you guys. So as you can tell, there's definitely more gap over here, which I kind of like. It definitely gives a little more, I guess, like room for air, if you want to call it. The front though is definitely super low, so I don't know if I'm gonna keep it this low, guys, or if I'm gonna adjust the height a little further than this. I do really like the way it looks, especially in the front. But I don't know, it's probably not the most practical thing, but it definitely looks really, really good. If I can give you guys like another shot over here, like the car looks 10 times better now that it's lowered. So if you guys are new here, this is a 2015 BMW 435. It is xDrive, and if you guys are familiar with these cars, xDrive models do come a little higher than the rear wheel drive variants. Things about like half an inch to an inch, somewhere between there. So this car originally was like riding super, super high, but now that it's lowered, it being like a coupe, which is pretty wide for it not being an M4 and all that, and now that it's lower, like it looks so good. I've had these coilovers on for a little bit now. I actually installed them like almost like a month ago, honestly. If you guys have been watching my videos, like you'll probably notice the car's been lowered for a little while. I just haven't gotten the chance to like actually make a video about these coilovers. Yeah, I figured it's about time. If I can actually show you guys the coilovers themselves over here. So if I don't know if you guys can see that, but there it is, the KW, and then in the rear, let's see if we can get like a good view of those as well. So I don't know if you guys can see that over there. You can probably just barely see the yellow spring, but definitely classic KWs with the yellow and purple. So again, sorry I didn't really get to film it, but we're just trying to install them, and you know, I don't know enough about these coilovers to make like a full DIY video about it. So if you guys watch my videos, you'll probably know that I talked about getting Bilsteins for this car. There's nothing wrong with the Bilsteins. The reason why I didn't get them was actually just because of like stocking reasons. That was actually my first choice, mainly because of the price. The Bilsteins are about like $1,000 or so. These KWs, they're great and they're amazing. I love them, but they're a little more expensive, about like 14 or maybe like 15 $1,500 or so. And I'll be honest, I don't think I would have noticed a difference between the build scene and the KWs in terms of like ride quality. I'm not a race car driver, so I feel like they both would have felt just as good to me. But when I tried to order the build scenes, they're unfortunately out of stock and they were back ordered for like a couple weeks. So the KWs were in stock, so that's why I went with these ones. Literally no other reason. So the build scenes that I was thinking about getting were the B14, which are very similar to these KW V1s. So if you guys didn't know, you can get KWs in V1s, V2s, and V3s. The difference between them is actually adjustability and of course price because of that. The V1s are towards the bottom. Then I also believe there's like another set that's called like the Comfort or something like that. The Comforts have no adjustability. The V1s you can adjust ride height. V2s and V3s you can adjust like dampening, compression, and all that type of stuff. Stuff that I wouldn't be doing personally on this car. Again, this car is pretty much just like a daily driver. I want it to be lower, so I didn't care about the V2s or V3s. V1s were definitely more than enough for me. I didn't want to spend like $2,000-$3,000 on coilovers. Just didn't make sense for this car. So speaking of adjustability, again, these are V1s, so you can adjust the ride height. You guys saw how low this car is. You can actually go lower if you want to. I did have to adjust the height a little bit, so let me actually cut to a clip of that and give you guys like an idea of what that's like. All right, guys, so I just want to take a quick clip showing you guys like what it's like to kind of adjust the KW coilovers. So to do so, obviously I took off the wheel so I can actually reach it. And then there's actually this little thing over here that basically like spins, if you guys can see those grooves over here. So what you basically do is you take the tool that it came with. So it actually gives you like this box over here and has a couple tools. The one that we want is of course this one over here. So basically how this works is you guys kind of like reach in here. It'll basically like grip onto it like this, if you guys can tell. To actually raise the car, you're gonna turn it, I think, counterclockwise, basically to the left. And then the other way, you guys just wanna put it like this, and then you turn it over to the right. So that's basically it. Obviously you wanna take measurements and all that type of stuff. I just wanted to give you guys like a quick idea. It's like to actually adjust these coilovers. They do give you this tool, so it does come with it, so you don't have to buy this separately. Obviously this is the rear, so the spring is kind of separate. For the front, it's pretty much the same process. You're just gonna have to like kind of lock this in and turn it, but obviously the spring is gonna be up higher, like by the strut, of course, like somewhere over here. I'm thinking I'm actually gonna have to adjust the front, so probably won't film that, but it's literally the same process. All right, so hopefully you guys enjoyed that quick clip. Again, I had to adjust the ride height a little bit. I did mainly the rear. Believe it or not, it was actually higher before than it is now. So the back was like super high and the front was super low. So it looked a little funny, but it definitely looks a lot better now. Yeah, of course, like one big benefit of getting coilovers versus springs or even like low-end coilovers where you have no adjustability, you can definitely adjust the ride height a good amount on these coilovers. So yeah, guys, like I was saying, you can definitely go lower if you wanted to. Personally, I wouldn't. This is super low in the front. I actually might raise it a little bit. The rear, I actually might lower it a little bit, make it a little more even. But yeah, if you guys wanted to, you can definitely go lower if you're thinking about getting the KW V1s. But overall, guys, like I think it looks super, super good. Again, let me give you another view of the other side and the better lighting. So the car looks, again, 10 times better in my opinion. Now that it's low, I think it completes the look with the new wheels, of course, and a whole bunch of other stuff that's done to the car. The car looked so funny before with just the wheels on without it being lowered, because of course they are bigger wheels. So it looked a little weird, but now with the coilovers on, again, it looks amazing. All right, so with that said, let's hop in the car. I'm gonna do like a quick review of sort of like how the coilovers drive. Of course, you guys seen them, you guys seen what they look like. So I wanna give you guys sort of like an idea of what it's like to actually drive them. So if you guys do wanna see that, definitely stay tuned. All right, guys, so like I was saying, I wanna give you like a couple clips of what it's like to drive the car with the coilovers, give you guys my thoughts on like how the coilovers feel, if it feels any better, any different than what it felt like on factory suspension. So I have the car in sport, have the transmission in sport as well. All right, here we go. Oh, this thing feels so good. Oh boy. Oh boy. Alright, so I pulled off to the side just so I can talk to you guys a little bit. The car feels so good. So the coilovers feel really good. I'm not gonna say it made like a night and day difference. These coilovers are pretty comparable to the original factory suspension on the car, at least like the sport suspension. This is an M Sport with the sport package and all that type of stuff. But anyways, it's not totally different. It does feel a little more stiff and firm. Like, it definitely feels a little more controlled. Something to note, guys, I do have a strut bar in this car. I do have wider tires. So originally this car comes with 225s all around. I have 245s in the front and 275s in the rear, so definitely an upgrade there as well. But in terms of suspension, it feels solid. It's not too stiff. I did go over some bumps, if you guys could tell over there. Nothing too crazy, but the car definitely soaks it up a good amount. Again, it's not harsh and it's not brutal. Like, it feels soft but sporty at the same time. Like, I wouldn't necessarily get these coilovers to go on a track, but I think for my purposes, so like a sporty daily driver, I think it's perfect. Just another reminder, these are the V1s, so if you guys do want something that's a little more stiff and firm and all that type of stuff, maybe the V2s or even V3s would be the route for you. The reason for that is obviously you can adjust that, so if you guys want it to be a little more firm, a little more tight, you can definitely make it that way. But on the V1s, all you can adjust is the ride height, so you're kind of stuck with like how firm it is, but you can adjust the ride height. Right now, I'm definitely too low, because even when I was leaving, I like scraped on a speed bump, so I'm definitely gonna have to raise it up. But again, in terms of suspension, it's a little more firm than factory. It's soft enough where it like soaks up a decent amount of bumps. Again, you know, this is not like an SUV, it's still sort of like a sporty car. So if you guys are just looking for like super comfortable ride, this is not it. But if you guys want a comfortable sporty ride, I think this is perfect. Again, V1s you can only adjust ride height, so if you guys want more adjustability, definitely go up to the V2s or the V3s. If you guys are looking into the Bilsteins versus the KWs like I have, the B14 you can adjust just the ride height, the B16 you can actually adjust dampening as well. So if you guys want that, look at the Bilstein B16. But if you guys want the equivalent of these KW V1s in the Bilstein, the B14 would be the way to go. So yeah guys, I mean, final thoughts on the coilovers. They feel amazing. I absolutely love them. I get so many questions from people about like, how do they ride? Does the car feel any better? Like, I'll be honest, I think it feels great. This is exactly what I personally wanted. I'm really glad I went with the KWs. So yeah, if you guys are debating getting the KWs for your car, hopefully this helps you out. Probably going to do another video comparing a whole bunch of different suspension types like lowering springs, coilovers, all that type of stuff. So if you guys want to see that, definitely stay tuned, hit the subscribe button. But before I end this video, I'm probably just going to take the car around that road one more time and just see, you know, just because why not. Yo, this car feels so good. Oh my god. I don't know, maybe it's this combined with the strut bar, the wider tires. By the way, I am on Michelin Pilot Sport ASs, so just in case you guys are wondering. But compared to before, like, this car just grips so much harder. That was an E36 that just drove by me, by the way. Yeah, definitely grips a lot harder. Like, it just, before the car felt a lot more floppy, but now it definitely feels a lot more stable. Like, for sure, it feels a lot more stable. Again, not a track car, but definitely a fun daily driver. All right, so that pretty much wraps up the video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you drop me a like, drop me a comment, guys. Let me know what you think about the new coilovers. And lastly, if you're not already, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Again, it'll really help me out. Anyways, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.